our weekly trip into the wild with Jack Hubley in tonight's Wild Moment, a wardrobe change to protect against the freezing cold.
A stunt like this makes you realize just how poorly equipped we humans are to survive in January without adding lots of artificial layers. A patch of hair here and there, and this sorry excuse for a fur coat, is laughable compared to the winter coats worn by other mammals. Take Skippy here. A layer of shiny guard hairs over thick woolly underfur allows the striped skunk to while away winter weather in complete comfort. And when it comes to thermal efficiency, an otter's oily two-layer coat makes him nearly as cold-proof and waterproof as a fish. But what about the white-tailed deer? That coat doesn't look nearly as warm as Skippy's until you look closer. And that brings us to Casey Sparks's question. She writes, "Why does deer fur change color?" Casey, just like you, the white tail changes coats from summer to winter. That reddish-brown summer coat is made up of short, thin hair follicles that are solid. Come late summer, deer literally change clothes. They shed their warm weather coat and replace it with longer hairs that are thicker because they're hollow. And the air trapped in those hollow hairs really holds the heat. Those cold weather hair follicles are gray-brown, accounting for the color change that you mentioned, summer red to fall brown. Wearing that thick, air-filled coat, a whitetail can ride out a January ice storm or cross a frigid river without a shiver, which is something I certainly can't recommend. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Okay. Because larger body size helps to retain heat, white-tailed deer in Canada are larger than average whitetails you see here in the Susquehanna Valley. If you have a wildlife question for Jack, email it to news8@wgal.com and you may see your answer on the air.